What's up, guys? Mike here, and it is the NBA trade deadline, baby! DeMarcus Cousins is on the New Orleans Pelicans. How cool is this? How awesome is this? We are living in a world where the two best big men in the NBA are now on the same team. I honestly feel like it's Christmas, and we still could have more trades coming. I mean, let's get our hopes up. I want to get my hopes up. I didn't expect this, and it happened, so I guess I shouldn't expect anything, and something good would happen. I don't really know what I'm saying. I'm very excited, though. So, we do not have network connectivity right now, but I don't think that really matters, because today, we are just taking a look at how the New Orleans Pelicans will do with DeMarcus Cousins on their roster. This is so sick. So sick! So, you know the deal at this point with these rebuild things. I guess this is more of just a scenario. We just turned off injuries. That's the only thing we turned off because who needs him? Who cares? We don't need that. I also don't think my roster might not be updated. Network connectivity, not really sure what that means. What it does mean is we can't download draft classes. Doesn't really matter though. Draft picks don't matter. We do have the roster because we have DeMarcus Cousins and Anthony Davis. So realistically, Lonzo Ball, Markelle Fultz, all those guys, they're not really going to play into this because what we're doing today, like I said, is we're going to see just how this plays out. Are the Pelicans good enough to compete for an NBA championship with this roster? And I'll give you a little hint right now. If we don't win in year one, which I don't expect to, year two is gonna get very interesting. A certain man might just be returning to New Orleans. A certain man who one day will be a Hall of Famer but has never played in an NBA Finals, let alone won an NBA championship. So today, we're gonna try to fix that. By the way, if you didn't get it, it's Chris Paul. But we're gonna finish out today's season first. Make sure everything's good to go here. Okay, we're just gonna use what the computer wants, except, you know, let's just get our boys a little more minutes, and let's do this thing. So, right now, the Pelicans are 2.5 games out. We've got to surpass Denver. There's only 25 games left. In real life, I'm really, really hoping it happens, because then we'll see the Warriors versus the Pelicans in the first round, which would be insane. I can't wait for DeMarcus Cousins and Draymond to kill each other. Here, though, it's not looking that great. Come on, baby, start getting some wins. We got Cousins and AD! Here we go, win streak. Chemistry's going up. Chemistry's going up. Beat the Rockets, big game. Okay, that's where we gotta beat the Grizzlies. All right, beat the Nuggets. Kings? Okay, if we lost to them, that would've just been very strong finish. Was it good enough? DeMarcus Cousins and Anthony Davis, all NBA first team already. Not good enough to reach the playoffs just yet, which, you know, is fine. We don't even need to waste time in the playoffs right now. We all know we want to see this first round matchup, Golden State Warriors versus Pelicans. So I'll sim just to make sure it happens, just for entertainment sake. This is an entertainment video. It's what the people want. At least I know it's what I want. And I hope you share my views from the six. Oh God, corny Drake joke. This is a Mike Wazemba video. You know, we're actually better off here because I'm also going to choose the Clippers just to make sure Chris Paul jumps into free agency. I mean, no matter what, he's gonna be on our team year two. But I wanna see if he is a free agent in this game, if he'll decide to join the Pelicans. We're in. We're in. Took a little bit. I mean, we were like winning games, you know, but they're just at a disadvantage. Only 25 games left, 2.5 spots back. Definitely far from a guarantee. Not even really gonna look at the numbers, honestly, because they're not gonna really change that much from what they really are right now. We'll do all that next year. I was thinking about this, and AD and Cousins were first team all NBA, and the team didn't make the playoffs. Like, yeah, NBA. That's not how you do things. Normally, your team needs to win to get awards. But I guess that shows the talent we got. Here we go. Golden State Warriors. This is what we all want. Over, under. Under DeMarcus Cousins, Draymond Green ejections in this series. Setting it at 2.5. Over or under? Comment down below. All right, lose the first, lose the second, lose the third, and we got swept. And so did the Clippers. All right, so our team is just Drew Holiday killing it. Good for him. Ooh, playoffs, 19-7. Good job, Drew. Way to go, buddy. All right, so our team, you know, Anthony Davis, 15 points a game, 42%. Cousins played better, 20-10. And he was a playoff virgin. Anthony Davis, we expect more, baby. I think you'd be excited that your team's finally relevant and you just do this against Zaza Pachulia in the championship? That happens in 2K far too often. Cavaliers, champions. Okay. By the way, keep forgetting to say this. I am rocking a Kings jersey today, and this is in memory of all our fallen Kings fans brothers. Kings fans, I'm very sorry for you. You're actually at the point where if you changed teams and became like fans of the Pelicans, no one would really judge you. In fact, I'm gonna say I would just be happy for you. You've had enough suffering. Just end your misery. Life is too short. But if you stick by your team, I respect that a lot. All right, player retirements. Don't care about this. Increase the shot clock to 45 seconds. What is this? Do they also wanna put peach baskets instead of rims? Like, yeah, let's make the NBA way more boring. It's a rejected. Draft lottery. You know the craziest part of this trade is that the Pelicans pick is top three protected. So let's say they don't make the playoffs and then luck out and win the lottery. The Kings don't even like get that pick. It's not like the Kings are like, oh, we traded away Cousins, but at least we got Lonzo Ball or Markelle Fultz or Josh Jackson, whoever you want. No, they would just not get the pick. The Kings are the worst. By the way, yeah, when I post this video, I will have a video up on the main channel, pretty much ripping into the Kings and how bad they are. So I'll leave the link down below. And also I'll leave the link to my thoughts on this whole incredible trade down below. Go check them out if you have not already. They are fire videos. Staff signing, head coach. This is big, baby. Greg Popovich, that's pretty realistic. Tyronn Lue, what happened? LeBron finally got tired of you. You know, I actually heard a really cool story that gave me a lot of respect for Tyronn Lue. A little off topic on this video, but in one of the first games, Tyronn Lue was the head coach. By the way, we need Kevin McHale, you know. I trust you, Kevin. We need a big man coach to coach our big men. But in one of Tyronn Lue's first games as head coach, LeBron apparently like went into the huddle and was like trying to direct the team and be coach LeBron. And Tyronn Lue literally looks at him. Tyronn Lue, you know, pretty short guy compared to LeBron. And was like, LeBron, sit down and shut the up, I'm the head coach. Sorry for the curse, but that's what he said. Give me a lot of respect for him. We don't need a trainer because injuries don't exist. Mullen, what are you mulling, Kevin McHale? There's one offer. Still mulling. All right, there we go. You know you want to be a part of this incredibleness. Okay, we're skipping the draft and everything because the Kings own our pick. Great job, Kings. You know, trading DeMarcus Cousins for Buddy Hield. Am I finally saying it's Hield, right? And a non-lottery pick. Great job, Kings, again. We do have our pick. Do I not understand this trade? All right, team player options, this is what matters. Accepted by him, Chris Paul, declined. Okay, there we go, good. All right, I'm just gonna let Chris Paul and Blake, you know, do their thing, test free agency. We've got Drew. So if we were gonna get Chris Paul, I think we need, I'm not really positive of the salary cap right now, I gotta look at it for the next video that I'm making, but I think we gotta just let Drew go for right now. Maybe we'll get him, maybe we'll pick him up later on, but we're going for the man Chris Paul right now. So we don't have enough cap space right now to offer $31 million a year. That is insane. That is a lot of freaking cash. How much could we offer? Nothing? Who's making so much money other than the Golden Boys? Don't call them the Golden Boys. That was like the worst tandem nickname I've ever heard of and given anyone, and I'm so sorry. All right, so we gotta get rid of Solomon Hill and Ashik, I'm assuming. Do it in one trade for Paul Zipser. Of course the Bulls would do this. Why not just destroy your salary cap, Chicago? I love being a Bulls fan. And you got rid of Paul Zipser. That would be like one of the low-key worst trades in NBA history. All right, we still cannot afford Chris Paul. We're close though. Gotta get rid of another like $5 million. Each one more has got a little bit of trade value. How about Ajinka? He's got nothing. All right, probably said that name wrong too. Just for a second round pick. Okay, we'll take it. Salary dump. There we go. We can legit offer Chris Paul like the max right now. I'm just curious, like what if we offered him like 24? Is that like horrible? Is he gonna, he just straight up declined. All right. Gotta give him over $30 million. You know, Chris Paul. The thing with Chris Paul in real life is that I could see him, you know, taking a little bit of a salary hit, taking a little of salary to go get a ring. Like the man is one of the greatest point guards of all time. The numbers don't lie. He literally is one of the greatest point guards of all time, but his historic resume isn't there because he doesn't have a ring. And if he could get one, that'd be so sick, dude. I love Chris Paul. I just want the best for you, Chris Paul. The 76ers are offering more money than me and he's more interested in going to the Sixers right now. Why do I just doubt that would ever be a thing? If I give him a player option and a no trade clause, the stupidest thing you could give someone. Accepted. Okay. Ba ba bang! Chris Paul, DeMarcus Cousins, and Anthony Davis all on one team right now. This is happening. If this happens in real life, I will freak out more than I already am over a 2K simulation. So Ian Clark only wants $1.81 million, which might be like the steal of the century. So that would be, you know, a pretty solid shooter to add to our roster. And can we add the dunk champion? The Mullen. Ian, let's go, baby. There we go. Okay, pretty happy with this offseason so far. And Yogi Ferrell, the reincarnation of Linsanity himself. Oh my God, look at this. Look at this offseason, boys. I think our team is very solid. Player progression, you know, if Chris Paul takes a little bit of a hit, it's okay. We still got a sick big three. And here we go, boys. Year two. So right now, our starting lineup is Chris Paul, Ian Clark, Quincy Pondexter, Anthony Davis, and DeMarcus Cousins. So obviously, you know, the key here is get as much shooting and defense we can get out of the shooting guard and small forward spot. And then just let the big three, you know, do the rest. So Quincy is a solid three-point shooter, and so is Ian Clark. So, I mean, I'm pretty happy with this, honestly. Maybe we'll, you know, try to make a move at the deadline, but for now, we're just letting it rock, baby. So here we go, Clippers, first game, Chris Paul's old team, take that. Grizzlies, oh God, all right. I forgot I am technically still coaching the Clippers. I do not want these Clippers trade offers. Only the Clippers? God, all right. DeMarcus, you're gonna lose to your old team like that? Here we go, chemistry. All right, I'm feeling it, chemistry's going up, Chris Paul can't do this, there we go. Now we're starting to gel. I'm saying that and we're still losing games. All right, we're gonna give it up till here. And then I think we're not doing as good as we hope, as we need to. So we might end up making a move. There we go, now we're gelling. Definitely putting up points, okay. 7-game win streak, it's all coming around. DeMarcus Cousins, 36-17 with 6 assists. 2 steals and 2 blocks, and Anthony Davis with 31 and 13, and Chris Paul 18, 7, 8, 6 steals. But these two guys, that's the kind of stat lines we're gonna be seeing. 30 combined rebounds and almost 70 combined points. Insane. Disgusting. Actually disgusting. All right, well, we're 7 in a row for right now. Maybe we should just, you know, chill till the All-Star break. Oh, 11-game win streak, though. We're doing it. This team has completely come around. Kings, can't do it, cuz you got it. There we go. That's the revenge. Dwight Howard for DeAndre Jordan. A gross trade. I wouldn't even post a YouTube video about that. I don't even know if I've tweeted about that. 37-17. Oh, okay, of course, I speak. Sorry, Pelicans. Here we go. Close out strong, baby. Close out strong. DeMarcus for Blake Griffin. Nah, we're good. All right, 40-18 at the All-Star break. This team is sick. Anthony Davis is averaging 29.1 points, 14.7 rebounds, and almost 3 blocks. He's having like one of the best seasons in NBA history. And Cousins is averaging 25.7, 13.5. 5.5 assists? Dude, Chris Paul's just changing the game. I'm surprised he's not averaging like 50 assists a game. Oh my God. Two guys in the MVP voting right now. 3 and 4. LeBron's almost averaging a triple-double. All right, Bron, I see you. Russell is averaging a triple-double. All right, so I'm targeting Will Barton as like the perfect, you know, small forward for us right now. A little bit undersized, but the man could shoot the three, he could D up, and Quincy Pondexter is just not good. He's completely and utterly horrible. See if this works. We got it, okay. First round pick, Tim Frazier, and we didn't really need Frazier. We got my man Yogi, who's on fire, by the way. More, you know, we're chilling. They're actually saying start Glenn Robinson at small forward. All right, we're gonna rock with this. Dunk champion and Will Barton in the starting lineup. This is a freaking sick starting lineup, I'm just saying. And if you notice me continuously changing controllers, it's because my controller keeps dying. PS4 is too far away to plug it in. It's a whole thing. Contract extension. DeMarcus Cousins, what are you undecided about? Our team is gonna be a dynasty, man. Chris Paul left out of the All-Star game. The disrespect. The man makes our team go. Without him, we were not good. I had to re-sim like 8 times to get into the playoffs even. Will re-sign DeMarcus Cousins, bang. Bang, happily accepted. We're happy to keep you, buddy. Everyone's happy these days. Warriors, huge test. Still can't beat the Warriors. Killing the Spurs, though. Killing it in general, though. Oh my God, this team is unreal. This could happen. This type of team could be on the court next year for the Pelicans. Spoke a little too soon. No, Warriors, come on. Can we just beat the Warriors for once? 57-25, though. Pretty great. LeBron James, player of the year. Yeah, we get it. AD and DeMarcus. First team All-NBA. That's sick. Chris Paul, though. No respect. We're the 2 seed. Okay. Playoffs, baby. It all begins today. I'm not going to overlook any team. We can't overlook anyone. All right, maybe I should have overlooked. No. Speaking a little too soon. Not speaking soon enough. Denver. 3 seed, good for you guys. Jokic killing it. What's his overall now? 87. Man's making moves, baby. They do have a nice team. Now just like none of us want them in the playoffs though, because we want Warriors, Pelicans, but sorry, Denver fans. Like, I get the Denver fans aren't happy here, but don't let them win. My God, the Warriors are about to lose up there. The Warriors lost to the Grizzlies. Grizzlies, low-key ridiculous team in this game. Pretty realistic too, guy. You Definitely don't need to fix your sim engine. All right, we're gonna lose to the Grizzlies too? Oh my, don't even tell me. Greatest comeback in NBA history. We just came back 3 games down. That's a new meme, boys. Never forget, Grizzlies blew a 3-0 lead in the 2018 playoffs. Comment that on other videos. No one will really understand it, but all comes down to this. You know we're doing simcast every time. Come on, oh my God, we just got destroyed? We got destroyed. Okay, on to the next one. What I say about my girls, it's what I say about my NBA finals games. I'm just kidding, I do not have girls. Cringy Mike Korzenba jokes 2, Cavs wins also 2. Pelicans, don't do this to me, we're so close. Come on, baby, come on. Grind out this win, it's looking good. We got it, okay. Gotta keep going, doesn't stop there. Oh no, fourth quarter, come back, come on. Oh my God, come back. No. 3-1, boys. 3-1. Pelicans? It's a lot of red. Oh my God, huge win. We're home. Just keep up this momentum. Get it. Oh my God, it's close. No, what happened? Okay. And there's our video, boys. We were so close. But yeah, that wraps up today's video. I only really like to do 2 seasons with this. Maybe if I do like a full rebuild for a team, I'll end up doing more one day. But I feel like 2 seasons gets you a good idea on what could happen. And the Pelicans made the NBA Finals. That's pretty incredible. And with Chris Paul, DeMarcus Cousins, and Anthony Davis all playing together, their future is a little bright. NBA trading season is our Christmas. Hope you guys enjoy. Subscribe if you're new, make basketball videos like this, do some quizzes. We dabble here and there. To everyone already subscribed, thank you guys so much. Your support means the world to me. You know this. And as always, have an awesome day. Cue that music. This could be us. So back to what I was saying.